Hallelujah. Father God, we honor you. We magnify you. We glorify you. For truly, you are an awesome God. Ah, as the songwriter said, I came on business for the King. Hallelujah. Father God, I pray that the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in thy sight, O Lord, my strength and my redeemer. I pray that your words will go forth with power, with conviction, with, oh God, restoration, with just encouragement on this morning, God. It will be a word in season, a word spoken, oh God, that will bring, oh God, revelation to your people, and oh God, a sense of comfort, a sense of confidence in knowing that our God reigns, and he reigns in majesty supreme. We thank you this morning for your love. In Jesus' name I pray, amen and amen. Our devotion this morning is entitled, Let God Do the God Stuff. Let God Do the God Stuff. Hallelujah. And our reference scriptures this morning is Isaiah 45 verses 5 to 7 and Proverbs 16 verse 9. Isaiah 45 verses 5 to 7 reads, I am the Lord and there is none else. There is no God beside me. I girded thee, though thou hast not known me, that they may know from the rising of the sun and from the west that there is none beside me. I am the Lord, there is none else. I form the light and create darkness. I make peace and create evil. I, the Lord, do all these things. Proverbs 16, verse 9 says, a man's heart deviseth his way, but the Lord directeth his steps. A man's heart deviseth his way, but the Lord directeth his steps. Praise be to God. Our devotion is entitled this morning, Let God Do the God Stuff. Hallelujah. One thing we love to do is have a plan. The world coined a phrase that says, if you fail to plan, then you plan to fail. There is absolutely nothing wrong with having goals and intentions for our lives and purpose. Hallelujah. Because God is a God of purpose. Hallelujah. The problem begins when we do not have God nowhere in the plans, or we do not consult him. Ecclesiastes 12:13 reminds us, let us hear the conclusion of the whole matter. Fear God and keep his commandments, for this is the whole duty of man. What is duty? The dictionary defines duty as a moral or legal obligation, a responsibility, a task or action that someone is required to perform. Wow. Let's say that again. Duty is a moral or legal obligation or a responsibility. A task or action that someone is required to perform. Romans 12:1 says, I beseech you therefore by the mercies of God that you present your bodies a living sacrifice, wholly acceptable unto God, which is your reasonable service. The problem is that we do not want to do our reasonable service, and we also want to step into the lane that belongs to God. This morning, let God do the God stuff and let God be God. We make our plans, that is okay. But we have to remember that many are the plans of a man's heart, but God is the one that establishes it. Proverbs 16:9 puts it this way, New King James Version. A man's heart plans his way, but the Lord directs his steps. So that goes to say that we need to keep our hearts pure and clean. And we can only do that when we have the word of God embedded on the tables of our heart and we meditate on them day and night. For out of the heart, as Proverbs 4:23 says, out of it flows the issues of life. So if in our heart we plan and we sit and we meditate, the word of God says, you cannot have evil and expect good to flow out. You cannot have good and expect evil to flow out. You cannot have your mouth being dirty and expect to worship a holy God. Everything has to line up. God is a God of principle, and he expects us to act accordingly, line upon line, precept on precept. Luke 6:45 tells us, a good man out of the good treasure of his heart bringeth forth that which is good. And an evil man out of the evil treasure of his heart bringeth forth that which is evil. For out of the abundance of the heart, our mouth speaks. Hallelujah. You want to know what's inside a person? Listen to them speak. If you're about spending time with God, when you open your mouth, you will show forth his praise. When you open your mouth, you will let God be God. You will know what is the God stuff on this morning, and you'll just yield yourself. For the word of God says, submit yourself under the mighty hand of God. Resist the devil, and he will flee. See, we need to be still, as Psalms 46:10 tells us, and know that he is God. And that he, God, will be exalted among the nations. He will be exalted in the earth. Let God do the God stuff on this morning. And you might ask, what is the God stuff? Well, in my life, the God stuff might be different for the God stuff in your life. You see, a 20-year-old might have plans and goals that is different from a 60-year-old. So what we put importance on depends on where we are in our lives. We need to know what our plans are and how they align with God's purpose for our lives. Many of us, we wanna have goals, and we wanna have plans. And when we say we're children of the Most High God, but they do not line up with what God's word says. The word of God says that we should not live or work or strive for wealth. Yes, God wants us to be prosperous. He said, I wish above all that you prosper and be in good health, even as your soul prospereth. You see, the key here, he says, even as your soul prospereth. How does your soul prosper? The word of God says, what would it profit a man to gain the whole world and lose his soul? We have one soul, but we will labor for everything else except to get our soul in the place that it needs to be, being ready for when the master returns. Let God do the God stuff on this morning. Many of us, we want to help God. I don't know if because God says in Psalms 82, he says, I have said ye are gods and all of you are children of the Most High. I don't know if we run with that part that says ye are gods, and we tend to have a God complex, and we want to take the place of God, and we sit in judgment seat of others, and we want to dictate others' lives, and we want to sit and we want to be the one that says, you know what, I put you up, I take you down, I do what I feel because I am a little God. I am a God. But let me tell you this morning, there is only one God. Isaiah 45 says from the New Language Translation, hallelujah, verse 5, I am the Lord. There is no other God. I have equipped you for battle, though you didn't even know me. See, God have equipped us for this life, for this life is a fight. Hallelujah. But it's a fight that we have already won. And we have won a fight that we don't even know the God that gave us, that has equipped us for this fight. God is saying this morning, get to know me. And when you know me, you will know the stuff that is in my hands, the stuff that is assigned to me. All of us, we have our assignments, and God has his assignment. God is the God of this world. He's in charge. God is the one that dictates. You know, you have a supervisor and you have workers. A supervisor supervises. God wants to supervise our lives. Just like the other day I said, God wants to usher us to our seat. God wants to be God. Let God be God. Do not put God in a box this morning and tell him, okay, God, you can be God in this. But when it comes to other things that we have to give up ourselves, things that we have to lay down our burdens, and we have to be who he wants us to be. For many of us, we have a calling, and you know, we need to make our calling and election sure, but we are dipping and diving, we're sitting, we're straddling the fence, and we want to be a child of God when it suits us. I know, I remember when I knew this lady, and she would always say, oh, I'll take off my earrings and grease up my face. I'll put down my salvation. And that always boggled my mind. And I've been like, how can you take off your salvation? See, if you've had an experience like the woman at the well that says, come see a man that have told me all things, hallelujah. If you have met the master, if you have had an encounter with him, Jesus the Christ, you will not take off and put on Christianity. You will not take on and put off your discipleship, your relationship with God. This is not like a relationship that you have with your husband. It is not like a relationship that you have with your children. Many mothers and fathers, they're estranged from their children. Husbands and wives, they have done separation. Oh, they're separated for right now. You cannot separate from the God of your salvation, because he is the potter and we are the clay. If we do not have him in our lives, how can he be God? If we pick and choose when we want God to work, how can he be God? He wants to be God of your life this morning. He wants to do the God stuff in your life. Hallelujah. He wants to be God. Hallelujah. But one thing that is generic for all of us, you might say, okay, so what is my God stuff? That's for you to figure out this morning. What are the God stuff that you need God to do? Because like I said, 20-year-old versus a 60-year-old, different place in life, have different goals, different purpose, and different plans, you know? And we need to figure out where we are at. But one thing that is generic for all of us is that we need to give all our fears, our doubts, and our unbelief over to God, as he is the only one that can bring all our desires and thoughts to pass. Hallelujah. Proverbs 16 verse 3 says, commit thy works unto the Lord, and thy thoughts shall be established. That has always puzzled me. He said, commit thy works. No, you're already doing it. But he says, commit your works and your thoughts, things that you're thinking about in the future, not even what you're doing right now. He says, commit thy works unto the Lord, and thy thoughts shall be established. What a wonderful thing. So you're doing something and you're thinking that, oh God, this is not working, but you're thinking of other ways that, you know, this can go. He said, commit those thoughts to God and watch God work. Watch him bring it to pass. Watch him establish it. When something is established, you can say it's etched in stone. When something is established, it gives you precedence. Like when you've had an encounter with God, you have precedence, something that you can reference. Oh God, as you walk this walk, you have a reference point that you can always look back and say, oh my God, you have done it before and you will do it again. Hallelujah. You have never failed me, so I know you can never fail me, because you have proven yourself over and over again. Commit thy works unto the Lord, and thy thoughts shall be established. I wish you can feel this thing like I'm feeling it this morning. Let God be God in your life. When you have to face certain situations and issues, I'm not saying it's going to be easy. Hallelujah. Because many a times we get amnesia, because when we're in the moment, all we can think of is the problem that is before us. And it takes discipline. It takes practice. It takes, you know, having spent time with God and building your confidence in God, just to let go and let God. Because one thing with man, we have control issues. We figure that if I'm not in control, then I don't know what's going on. Let God be God in your life this morning. For Psalms 37 verse 4 says, delight thyself also in the Lord, and he shall give you the desires of thine heart. Delight yourself in God. You know, some of us have some desires that when you think about them, it makes you shudder, because you're like, how in God's name can I bring this to pass? He said, delight thyself in the Lord. Delight thyself in the Lord. Meditate upon God day and night. Meditate upon his words. Put God first in all that you do. Do that which he has asked you to do, and he will bring it to pass. In Matthew, he says, oh God, seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things shall be added unto us. When we seek God first, everything else shall be added unto us. It doesn't matter what it is. Hallelujah. For the word of God said, all good and perfect gift cometh from the Lord, from above, from the Lord, that there is no variable of turning with him. Hallelujah. Hallelujah this morning. Let God be God in your life this morning. Hashtag. the God stuff. Hallelujah. The God stuff. Hallelujah. Mighty God, I honor you this morning. Teach me to let you be God all by yourself in my life. Teach me to let you do the God stuff. Hallelujah. Father God, I ask that, oh God, you will just give us an inkling, give us a confirmation in our hearts this morning that this is your desire for us to lay everything down and be, oh God, this be our reasonable service, being a living sacrifice. So God, you can do that which you have purposed and called us to do. For, oh God, how can we, the clay, tell the potter what is our intention, what you have created us for? For you are the creator of all the ends of the earth. You are God from beginning to the end. There is no place for argument this morning. You are God all by yourself. Hallelujah. Father God, we thank you for your love, your mercies, and your grace. We thank you for your keeping power. We ask that you continue to be with us and as we meditate upon your words, so that your words will come alive unto us, oh God, and we'll start, let you be God in our lives. Have your way, we pray, in Jesus' name. Let God be God in your life. Hallelujah. Let God do the God stuff this morning. May God bless you.